Back inside the Metropolitan Museum where last night's gala took place, the doors are getting ready to open for Manus Ex Machina, an exhibition exploring the role of technology in fashion and how designers are reconciling the handmade and the machine-made in their creative process. Some of the most unusual creations on display come courtesy of a Dutch designer who we went to visit.
Some ateliers really go for the craft and some ateliers really go for the technology, but I notice when you bring them together, a lot more possibilities start to grow.
From her Amsterdam studio, Iris van Herpen has been pioneering the high-tech fashion movement. In 2010, she was the first designer to send a 3D printed dress down the catwalk. Her otherworldly designs use the latest in technology. From laser cutting and ultrasonic welding to synthetic fabrics and 3D printing. Fans include Bjork, Beyonce, and Lady Gaga.
Now I definitely see my space of couture as a laboratory. It's the place where art and fashion can really merge as well, where I can collaborate with someone completely outside of fashion.
Iris van Herpen's ideas come from a variety of unusual sources. She's been inspired by the sculptures of David Almaid and the vacuum installations of Lawrence Malstaff, the architecture of Philip Beasley, and the microscopic photography of Stephen Geschmeisner. For her, technology is a much-needed stimulus and a new means of expression.
I think the magic sometimes of technology is really the invisibility of it. Technology becomes so small, you almost have to imagine the process behind it. I've been going underground to the Large Hadron Collider, where they experiment with the tiniest building blocks of our lives. I think that's a very big trigger to me to find my own visibility in it. I try to sort of translate them into the materiality.
To translate science into materials takes research. From tests with magnetic particles alongside designer Jolan van der Veel to slow motion experiments in water alongside the photographer Nick Knight.
The beauty in the 3D prints are really in their seamlessness, and they actually really remind me to processes in nature where you see very tiny lines being built up almost like a fingerprint, and I couldn't go that complex and that detailed if I would have done some of the pieces by hand. I'll show you the dragon skin dress that will be shown at the exhibition Manus Ex Machina in the Metropolitan Museum. It's a dress made from dragon skin. It's a process of several months where we start making a base layer from clay, then pouring over one layer. It's a really tricky technique. Here you can see the first one that we did. We made a mistake with the very last layer, so this was a work of 3 months of several people, last layer filled, and we had to start all over again. So this unfortunately has to go into the bin. Yeah.
Often fashion is advanced, as in any other art form, by errors or mistakes. And I wonder, can a machine make a mistake? I think what's interesting is that some designers are trying to use the machine to give the illusion of the hand by coding in mistakes. Can a machine advance fashion without the hand, without the presence of humanity? And I'm not sure it can.
I think once you isolate technology on its own, it becomes a very cold medium. It's the people behind it that can create something really beautiful with it. In some years from now, we won't even be talking about technology or craftsmanship. I really think they will fuse together and there will not be such a big separation anymore.
After the break, we head to the city which many consider to be the heaven of the handmade, where the world's leading design fair is underway.